Okay, let's get started with our upper body. Remember, you need your light and heavier set of dumbbells right next to you. So we're gonna warm up. Just go ahead and roll your shoulders back. Good, how about a couple more like that? You're just gonna reach up right and left. So take a nice big stretch side to side. Then I'm just gonna have you pause at the top. So three again. So you can always do these on the knees. Kind of choose which level feels good for you today. Great, let's alternate again. Now both come up. Let's do a few more like this, alternate. Now when you bring the weights at the top, just watch me for a minute. I'm really thinking about squeezing, almost like I'm bringing my upper arms closer together at the top. That. Excellent, let's slow this down again. So open out, just smoothing it out. Open it up. Now take this a little bit faster. Nice, two more. Let's try alternating that high V raise again. Here we go. Open it up and open. Now head in line with the spine. So you're not looking at me right now. You're looking out in front of you. Four more. Breathe. Two more. Three, good, last two. Hold it up now, bend the elbow. Here we go, kick it back, we have eight. Three, I know you're feeling your upper body, I am. Hold it right there, slowly, bicep curl, let it come down. Pick it up. Now, we've worked the whole upper body. So use this as an opportunity to kind of line up your form. Notice how your weight is distributing through the foot. Yeah, because oftentimes we have a tendency to kind of roll to the outside or the inside of our foot, getting a little balance and stand. And you know, some days you're gonna have more balance than other days. It's okay. Sometimes we're stronger than other days and you just have to go with it. You're having a good day, pick up heavier weights. That's it. One more time, just like that. Stand at the top. So check it out. I'm gonna put the weight into the other hand. I'm still on that right leg. This leg is for balance. We're gonna do a little series. So you squat down, tap it out, bring it in and stand up. So we have a little pulse at the bottom, check it out. We're gonna go low, a little bit, down and up. Strong, good. So it's a little hover and I'm really feeling my hamstrings right now. Remember, the back leg can lift or not. Down and up. We have four more. Nice. Gotta work. I know everybody likes to work their glutes. We all do, right? Important to get them strong. They kind of turn off a lot during the day because we are sitting so much. Three, hang in there with me. Two, one more, one more. Up. One more. Good. Now hold over in that hinge. Stay right there. I know you're feeling it. Take your back leg. You're gonna tap it in, out, lift, and lower. More. Little variation. Check it out. Get over to the leg. Lift the opposite leg. Oh, lift. Ouch. Right. All right. Now, one more time. Give a little alternating lunge jump. Check it out. You have four, three. Hold it right there. Two more sets. That was our bell. One more. That means this is coming to an end. Side to side. Excellent, you got four. So you have a power jack, check it out. Diagonal lunge. So right now I'm thinking sink. Easy through the legs. The more you do it, kind of the stronger you get. Single, kick back. But you also get to know the moves a little, so you'll feel more confident in them all the way. One more. Okay, sumo squat down and up, two of them. Strong. Here's the stretch, weights down, hips high. Stand tall. Do it. So you're gonna hop side to side. Hey, if you're not feeling super bouncy, you can always take it low or come up. Back. Lift. Oh, there was that bell. Yes. Knees up. Pick it up, pick it up. Two, step in and lift. Yes. Oh yeah, pulsing twice. Or you can do a lunge jump, but make sure that you lift your chest up. One more. Come on, we're on our home stretch here. Ramping it up already, right? Two squat or two jacks. squat slow. Bend those knees. Now check it out. Bring it right here. Right here. Squat. Press. Press. That's it. Do it again. You got it. Squat down. We're going from the top. Alternate. Step knee. Step it. Yes. Now corner to corner. Maybe a little power. Up. Yes. Knee ball change. Step ball change. Scissor back. Uh-huh. So two steps. Scissor back. So quick feet. Do it again. Up. Up. Back. Box step. Yep, we're going from the top. Mambo, front and back. Two, go. Do it again. Come on, big twist. Again. So sit nice and tall. This is proud pigeon first. Try to feel the stretch through the glute, and you're on the top of that back thigh. Shut, then back to the center. Go the other way, lower down. Now in the center, I just want you to easy jack out and in. Now on that upright row, remember, I like to bring my thumbs towards my armpits. Let's do a couple more. My heart rate's coming up. A few more like that. This time we're gonna do two of the lifts. Here we go. Now you're getting the front of the shoulders and you're definitely getting some core work right here. Draw the abdominals in. Little dip in between, two more. Let's go back to our regular dip. Just the elbows are bending. So that means you cross row. Yes. How you feeling? Second side, usually we fatigue out a little more because we've done so much more, right? Yes. One more time. One more time. Come back in, but then put your head in line with your spine and focus on what your body's doing. Let's just do like one more each side. A lot of work going on. Take the top arm, you're gonna reach it like you're threading the needle, and then you're gonna come up. Do it again, so thread the needle and come up. So I'm alternating the direction of the circle, and honestly, it's more like an oval. Give me a little pulse. If you're feeling too much strain on the neck, okay, take a hand behind the head or both of them. Two, three, and down. So you're trying to twist a little further each time. Lower. Now give me three pulses right here. Three, two, one, and down. Nice. One more each side. Woo! Excellent, you guys. All right. I told you it was the last one, but give me a little hover. Take your legs up just so your lower back's on the ground. Good way to get the body moving. We'll do one more like that. Now notice my feet are apart a little bit. So I've got my right leg out to the side. And then you can just draw like little circles with your hips. My husband likes to call this the mixing bowl. You're gonna take your right leg, you're gonna shoot it over to the side. So we're gonna stretch that IT band and you're just gonna let your hips come down. Wow. The back over that top thigh, kind of push down and then swing and open. And again, so we're just gonna move through this. And again, feel free to go at a pace that feels right for you. And you know, if you haven't done this before, you know, be a little easy with yourself. Go easy. The more you do it, the more comfortable it becomes. It actually feels really good. One more. Holding back in that hip. Abs are in, body is long. Come forward and back. Nice. Just go where you're comfortable. It's work and it's flexibility.